Hi there and welcome to this video. In the last video, I showed you how to create a Shopify store via the Shopify partners account. In this video, I'm going to do an overview of the Shopify dashboard. If you're new to Shopify and you don't know how to use Shopify, you're going to see how to work with the dashboard. So first off, let's log into our development store. So if you come here under stores, you'll see all the stores that you've created via the Shopify partners account. And the one we created was called Partner Sample. And if you want to log into it, just click on Login. So here on the homepage, on your dashboard, you'll see that there are quick links that you can use to get started. Number one, you can see you have the option to add your first product. You can customize your online store. This will allow you to go and edit the theme that you're using, change different pages, edit pages. If you need to add blog posts, you'll see how to do that under this link. You can do that there, but we're going to see that is inside here. Add a custom domain. This is something you can do once you've built your store, or even when you're still building it, you can add a custom domain so that you don't use a .myshopify subdomain. And I have a video for doing this. I will add it in the description. If I forget, just remind me. Sometimes I forget. Set up Shopify payments. If you want people to buy products from you, you'll have to set up various payments. And Shopify has lots of different payment options that you can set up, that you can just set up right here within your dashboard. Now on the homepage, that's what we've looked at, right? So we're going to go down like that. Let's start with orders. Now orders, as the name suggests, this is where you're going to get any orders that are currently pending. You'll see the orders here, and then you can fulfill them. If you have any draft orders, these are orders that did not go through. You can also look at shipping labels. And I want to bring your attention down here. On every element you're going to click on, you're going to see that there is a Learn More option that you have here. This will take you to the Shopify documentation where you can read anything you don't understand. So if you want to learn about anything, just click on the Learn More option that is provided down there. Now you can also set up purchase orders. If you want to deal with suppliers and all that, you're getting products, you can create purchase orders right here on Shopify and manage them through Shopify. And then transfers, you can transfer products if you have incoming items. So you can use the inventory system in Shopify to transfer your products. Of course, you can read more about that and learn everything that you need to learn about it on this page. Just click there to learn more about it. And then gift cards, you can give gift cards to your customers. If you're doing promotions, you can do that there. And then catalogs. So it's important to note that this is not available on every plan, but since I created the account using the Shopify development store, it gives me all the options that are available. This is not available on every plan, so you have to note that. And then customers. So you can add customers. You can import customers. If you have customers, they will be listed here. People that have bought from you, you'll find them on this page. Of course, you can have companies that are customers. So of course, this is also available on different plans. And then content. And then for content, there's this new thing in Shopify, meta object. So you can add custom types of objects into your Shopify store. Maybe you want to add various features for a product. You can do that using this. Let's just do an example. Let's click there and see the options that we have. So you can add a meta object. Maybe you want to add certain features for your products. Give the product a name, maybe its size, and then you add a field. And of course, I'm not doing a tutorial for this now. I'm just going to cancel this and then I will close. But you can read more about meta objects right there. And then of course, files. If you have files, images that you want to use in your stores, videos, documents, and so much more, you can add files into your Shopify store and use them on any element in your store, in your marketing, and so on. And then analytics. you can look at the different analytics for your store. Under analytics, you can see how your store is performing. So look at that here. All these different types of metrics that you can look at. You can even add custom metrics. And reports, you can create, for custom, you can create custom reports, and then you'd be able to view them under your analytics. So there are lots of different reports that you can have a look at. And then the live view, if your store is live, you can see if there are any visitors right now, any sessions, any sales that are happening, all that is possible in here. And then under marketing, so if you scroll down, you can read more about marketing campaigns and so much more. So you can set up marketing, create a campaign. If you click there to create a campaign, you can create ads, you can use Bing, all this, Pinterest, Snapchat. You can also set up email campaigns. You can email, you can target Shopify email for $1, 1,000 emails per month. If you want to set up email marketing, click there and have a look at the options. And then, of course, all these are available on the Shopify App Store. And then campaigns, of course, if you set up any campaigns, you can see how they're doing in there. Automations, so you can set up automations, abandoned checkout, you can preview it. Abandoned carts, remind customers they left items. You can turn this on. Any element that is here, you can click to turn it on. So this feature is turned on by default. You can click on it to see the options that you have. Abandoned checkout emails by Shopify. Under the abandoned cart, you can see these are what metrics you'll be able to see for it. And you can also edit the settings. You can change the settings for your abandoned cart. Have a look at that and see the options that you have. So we have looked at marketing, campaigns, automation. That's where we have the abandoned cart. And then discounts. You can give out discounts. You can create discounts. So you can click there on discounts and read more about that. If you want to create discounts, you'll just click there. And you can create different types of discounts. Amount of a product, of a product, or you can create amount of the full order. And then buy X, get Y, you understand that. And then free shipping. So you can create discounts that can be added by customers, or you can apply them for your customers. And then let's look at the options that we have under online store. So first of all, if you want to preview your store, you can click there on that, on the eye icon, and that's going to take you to your online store and you can preview the store. So it's important to note that when you're building the store, there will be a password. So not everyone can access the store. If you want to find the password for your store, you'll click on online store and you can find it under preferences. Or you can just click there to see the store password. This is the one that you'll enter into the store to access it. Now I'm able to access it because I'm logged into my store. So if you click there on online store, you have all these options. The first one we have is themes. You can change the different themes for your store. If you want to change a theme, you can come in here and you can preview the theme. You can see right now I only have one theme. If I need to add a theme, I would need to add a theme to my theme library. All I have to do is I will go into add theme and I can visit the theme store. Or if I have a premium theme that I bought from anywhere or I customized or built, I can upload it. You can also connect your theme from GitHub, especially if you're a developer, you can connect that from GitHub. But I think this is available because I'm logged in as a developer in my Shopify partners account. You can visit the theme store. So if I was to visit the theme store, let's look at the themes that we have. So if you come to the theme store, you're going to see there are different themes. You can click there to view all themes, and you can view them based on price, free themes. So for every theme, you can always click on it. Let's say this is the one that appeals to you. You can click on it and you can view a demo store. You can try the theme. So you can view a demo store. You can try the theme. Let's say I click on try the theme. It will be added to my online store themes. Initially, I only had this. Now I have two and I can publish this. If I publish that, it will become the default theme. And that is the theme that I can now use. If we go and preview, let's see if there is any difference. And you'll see that the theme has changed. If you need to customize your pages, you can customize your pages. And all this you can see in my free Shopify tutorial. Blog posts. Shopify by default has the blogging capability. Come here under blog posts and you can write a blog post. And then under navigation, there will be an option for you to add the blog page. That is possible under navigation, also available in my free Shopify tutorial. And then pages, you can create new pages. You can add a page, create pages. If you need to add an about us page, click there, add the page. Navigation, you can set up the navigation, remove items from your menu, add items on your menu. You can see there are two menu locations, the footer and the main menu. You can add different menu items in there. And then preferences. So this is where the password comes in. If you want to change the password for your store, you'll just scroll down and you'll see the password is there. You can change it, share it with people that want to look at your store. Maybe you want someone to preview the store. You can send them this password and they will be able to access your store. Something else that is here, the homepage title, you can add that there, SEO friendly. Description, SEO friendly title, you can add all that there. And then the social sharing image, when people share your store, what image should be prominent on the social media preview? So you can add an image right there. Set up Google Analytics, you can add your analytics code right there from Google. Facebook Pixel as well, you can set up Facebook Pixel with your Facebook account. And then privacy policy, choose when you collect data. And you can see there's this option for B2B. This I think is available on a different plan. My store was created via the development store and therefore it comes with all the features. You can enable spam protection. So just go through settings, through online store preferences and see what options that you have there. And then point of sale. So Shopify has a point of sale. And if you have a brick and mortar store, you can set up the point of sale. So you just choose where you sell and then start from there. And then you will be guided through the process of setting up your point of sale. You can add your stuff. For your point of sale, you can add your stuff. You can add the locations for your store. And you can change the settings. So once you start from here, you'll be able to change your settings. So you can look at the different apps here and you can find more apps in the Shopify App Store. If you need an app for anything, you'll usually find that there's already an app that can do what you need done. So just go to the Shopify App Store and look for the app that will fulfill the need that you have. For example, if you're looking for a dropshipping app, you can always go to Shopify App Store, find that. If you're looking for a digital sales app for you to sell digital products, you can look at the Shopify App Store and make sure you look at the different reviews so that you can select one that is reliable and won't let you down. So that's it here under apps. Now, the next one, let's look at settings. There's a lot here. So let's just click there on settings and we're going to go through them if we can finish all of them. And then you can choose your store defaults. Give you the store name and all the details for your store. You can edit that there. And if you also need to change the currency for your store, the location for your store, the store currency, you can change that there. All these other different settings you can change as well. Come in here and look at the options that you have. And then under your plan, you can choose a plan that you want to use for your store.